More breaking news tonight, and it's a big deal. An ABC Action News I-Team investigation could prompt a nationwide recall.
That's right. Our I-Team reporter Jackie Calloway has spent months reporting on spontaneous fires igniting popular cars. And Jackie, you're getting late word some of those cars might soon be recalled.
You know, Woody, we've been trying to get answers from Kia for months, and just 2 hours ago, the car company sent me this plan to recall nearly 70,000 vehicles to check for potential fuel pump leaks. Now, the announcement comes 2 months after we first brought the issue of these leaks to the company's attention. In November, auto experts told the I-Team that fuel pump leaks resulting from faulty work done during engine recall replacements could be causing some of these fires. Several of the drivers we've interviewed say their cars underwent recall work in the months and weeks before their Kias burst into flames. In at least two cases, parents had to pull children out of the burning cars and narrowly escaped with their lives. Despite the planned recall, Kia is saying it's not aware of any accidents or injuries resulting from these fuel pump leaks. Now, the U.S. Attorney's Office has reportedly launched an investigation into whether Kia handled the engine recalls properly, but this is the very first time Kia has admitted there may have been a problem with that original recall work.
Wow, this is a huge story, and thanks to your reporting, this has been months in the making. Where does it go from here? Because I imagine someone has some explaining to do.
Well, they do, and Kia spokesperson that we spoke with tonight actually said in the email a bit of a caveat. He said they can't officially go forward with the recall until the government shutdown is over, and NHTSA federal regulators are able to approve that.
Many more developments to come, Jackie. Thank you. Well, you can see all of Jackie's reporting, including her two-year quest for action and answers, on a special section of our website, abcactionnews.com/carfires.